Hi, I'm Jennifer Reed, Associate Scientist in the Division of Prevention and Rehabilitation at the University of Ottawa Heart Institute. I'm here today to talk about electronic cigarettes, e-cigarettes. Point one, e-cigarettes are cigarette-shaped canisters used to simulate the action of regular tobacco smoking. Within these canisters, there are batteries, and these batteries are used to heat up fluid-filled cartridges that contain varying concentrations of a number of different chemicals, such as propylene glycol, water, glycerin, flavoring agents, and nicotine. The act of smoking an e-cigarette is called vaping because the user actually inhales vapor as opposed to smoke. Point number two, although these products are readily available either online or through a number of retail outlets, they are not regulated or approved for sale in Canada. This is a bit concerning because the interest in e-cigarettes is rising, although again, these products are not regulated or approved for sale. Point three. Although perceived to be a safer alternative than typical tobacco smoking, electronic cigarettes, e-cigarettes, have not been fully evaluated for their safety. We need long-term research trials to truly evaluate the safety of these products. It's unknown whether the inhalation of the chemicals or products found within these devices are in fact safe. Point four, these products, e-cigarettes, have not been fully evaluated for their effectiveness. Are they effective? We don't know at this point. There has been, though, one recent randomized control trial which evaluated the effectiveness of cigarettes compared to nicotine patches. However, due to the low abstinence rates that were found in this trial, the results were proved to be inconclusive. We couldn't determine whether, in fact, these devices, e-cigarettes, were in fact superior to nicotine patches. There's also a concern with these products that they may help to maintain a dependence in current smokers or induce a dependence in those who aren't already smoking. Point five, our last point. What do we recommend for smokers who are wishing to quit? Well, there are a number of first-line evidence-based interventions that have been proven to be successful, and those include both pharmacotherapy and behavioral options. Speak to your healthcare provider to find out more information about these specific interventions and treatments that may work best for you. Thank you.